Hello everyone, I am SP Mankani, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to study working of meter in circuits. So at the end of this lecture, students will be able to understand the working of meter in circuits. Meter in flow control, this is what we are going to be calling it as a meter in circuit. So here, so I will explain all the detailed components of this meter in circuits. So then we will go by the working of this. So here the tank, that is the storage tank, then it comes to the cell. This has a pump. The whatever the oil is going to be pumping in the upward direction, if there is a pressure is more than the designed or defined pressure, so then it will be through this relief valve, it will come back to the tank. So while it is going in the upward direction, so here there is a directional control valve. So in this direction control valve, we are going to be calling this as a 4x3, means 4 ports and 3 controls. So here whenever you are going to be operating this knob, so through that one we can have the control of this one. The middle one is related with the normal flow. So means in this middle one, whatever the flow is going to be through this way, it will come back to the once again to the storage tank. So here we are just in this diagram, we have connected this one as for the flow in the upward direction, and that flow is coming through this one. So means we are going to be calling it as 4 ports and 3 positions. So that is what it is, a 4x3 directional control valve. The first one is related with the ports, 1, 2, 3, 4 ports, and the second one is related with as a 3 positions. We can change this position of this directional control valve. So through this, then it, the flow is going to be taken this one as flow control valve. So here it is a flow control valve. So here this is restricted. There is no flow through this particular direction. Only flow is going to be through this way. So then this flow is going to be controlled here. And this one we are going to be considering the cylinder and piston arrangement. So where this is a load is provided on this particularly, this one means the total working of the system of this one is load is coming through this particular way. So the outlet of this one is once again, it is flowing through this particular way, and here it is a flow is going to be taken place, and this is restricted now. This is restricted. So here the flow is going to be taken place through this way, it will come back to the storage tank. So means from the source, pump, then directional control valve, and then the flow control valve, then it comes to the piston and cylinder arrangement. So here we will go with the this red color indicating it as a high pressure oil is going to be flowing through this way. So oil is going to be pumped from the tank. So there is a pressure compensated pump. So here this oil is coming through this particular way because we have adjusted. These 3 slots we can adjust any one of this one depending upon the requirement. This is normal condition. This is normal one. And this is, we can have the reverse direction, and this is a regular direction. So here this will come through this way. So when the flow is going to be taken place through this way, because we can control this one, this is controlling nothing but this, we can control it. So this is controlling nothing but this one. So whatever the defined after regulating this one, valve, we are going to be sending this high pressure oil through this one. So here the load, whatever the load is acting on this particularly area, so that is going to be pushing it backside. So this is going to be pushing it back side. So then this side, whatever the oil is available on the back side of the piston, that oil is coming through this way and it will come here. So here the flow control valve is now opened here. So through this way the oil is going to be coming through this one, and through the directional control valve it come back to the storage tank. So here this is not in active condition. So actually the meter in flow control means whatever the oil is going to be supplying to this particular cylinder, the inlet is going to be controlled here. Means this is what we are going to be calling it as a meter inflow control. So means the oil is coming through this way and it will go to this one. Means inlet is going to be controlled here. So this portion is going to be controlled for inlet. We are not going to be controlling this one. We are going to be controlling only inlet side. So I am explaining the related with as a inlet to this one. The same thing we are going to be applying the concept for this also in the next diagram. We are going to be applying the same concept by changing the position of this one. So in this totally you are going to be understanding as the high pressure oil is coming through this way and this is direction control valve, then it will come to this one as a flow control valve. So through this way it will come to the piston cylinder arrangement, and piston is going to be pushing backside, and because of that whatever the oil is available here it will come through this way and it will directly flow to the reservoir. This is one type we are going to be studying. Another one is we are going to be changing the position, that is a 4x3 wall. We are going to be changing the position of the wall. So here in the previous diagram, this is controlled. In this diagram, this is what we are going to be controlling it. So here the flow, whatever it is coming, so just we have changed the position of this one. The previous diagram, the position is this one. Now we are going to be shifted this one to the this side. So now we have shifted this one. It is a reverse direction we are applying. Means inlet is going to be in the back side of the piston. Inlet is going to be the back side of the piston. So now the flow is going to be taken place. Once again, the motor is going to be operated and the high pressure oil is flowing through this way and it will come to this one. So now this is not in, this is not allowing the this oil to flow this side. It is a closed now. So this oil is going to be flowing through this way, controlled wall, flow control. So this way it will come to this one. Means it is going to be pushing it back to the original position. So this is going to be pushing it back. So in this case, this is going to be, the piston is going to be moving in this direction. So while it is moving in this direction, so that time whatever the oil is available here, it will come through this way. So now in this important thing is, so this is not in working condition. This is not in working condition now. So this is flow is going to be flowing through this way and it will come back to the this end here. The connection is given to this, the reverse direction, that will come back to the reservoir tank. So here, once again, we are going to be controlling inlet side. In the previously we are controlling here also inlet. So here the meter inflow is nothing but we are going to be controlling whatever the oil is going to be flowing inside the piston. Either it is in the front side or it is in the back side. The reverse of this one we are going with the next as meter out system. So here once again the working of this one you are going to be understanding with the next this clip, the working model of meter in circuit. Here you can observe it. So the oil is going to be flowing this way. This path is going to be taken place and through this one it will come to this one. And here it is not allowing to flow. So here this is a high pressure oil is going to flowing through this flow control wall. So then it will come to this one. This is going to be repeated. So now the oil is going to be flowing in this way. So it is reversed. Means it is, we are shifted to the another side out of these three control. So flowing this way and load is coming this side and this one outlet, it will come through this way. It is, once again I will repeat the same thing, flowing taking place like this, the control is going to be taken place, inlet, meter in, so that will come here, the outlet is coming through this way without any resistance, it will flow back to the reservoir. Here it is come back to the reservoir. Arrow mark is indicating the flow and red color indicating as a high pressure. And here blue color is back to the reservoir. The same thing, we have shifted this one, next in this shift shifted to the reverse direction. So now the flow is going to be taking place through this way and it will come to the back side of the piston. Now it is moving in the forward direction. At the same time, this flow is in the normal condition, it is coming back to the reservoir. Through this one, it will come back to the reservoir. So just it is for the working model, the meter in circuits. So just let me know the what are the application of meter in circuits. What are the application of meter in circuits? So here one thing you understand as what exactly the flowing is going to be taken place inside, by that one utilization how exactly you are going to be considering it as a working, and that applications, what are the application of meter in circuits. A metering circuit is ideal in application where a load always offers a positive resistance to flow during a control stroke. Positive resistance to flow during a control stroke. Just you see this line as a positive resistance to flow during a control stroke. Okay, this is what you are observed in the diagram also. So here the examples would be feeding grinder, tables, welding machines, milling machines and rotary hydraulic motor drives. So here, once again, just this is a line I'm explaining as a positive resistance to flow during a control stroke. So just you can observe it. This is a positive resistance to flow during this control. This is what we explained there in that particular diagram. So here, for this further details, you may refer this particular site even as an oil hydraulic system by SR Mojumdar. Thank you.